Good evening, everybody. Terribly sorry about that little bit of hiccup in the start. Now, one of the things which we were talking about is we were wanting to see how we can go for the shuttering, especially for the column element. And basically, we have done this on an earlier occasion, but probably very, very fast. So I was just going through some of the previous classes which we had worked. So I hope that you guys kind of at least remember that we have done this particular thing. If you notice here, this is a multi-story building for which people are just starting to do the shuttering. You will have to keep the props at the floor below for some more time till this slab gains strength. After that, you can remove it. So what happens actually is the number of props which you will require is slightly more than what you typically work on. Okay, so maybe for a particular floor you need a certain number of props, but you should always remember that only after the floor below has hardened, gained strength. I shouldn't say hardened. The floor below has gained the target strength, you can go to the floor above. So one of the things we also spoke in the previous lecture was about the use of different kinds of cements. So some of the cements are able to gain strength very quickly. And on the other hand, some of the cements take a very long time to gain strength. So you need to be very cautious in the type of cement, based on the cement you use, based on the materials which go in. Maybe you are using an admixture which is going to delay the setting of concrete, but give much higher strength. Or you are going to add some admixture which is going to give strength very quickly. So as a construction engineer, you are expected to know the properties of the materials which you are using. Now, another very important thing which I'd like to point to is, now look at in this structure, you can see that in the first floor, they started to do the work on the walls. Okay, so walls are slowly starting to be done. So maybe first floor has been fully completed. Second floor is work in progress. And third floor, they started to take up the blocks and keep it ready for the work to start. Okay, so these are some of the aspects which you try to see. The sequence of work, how much of material it's required, and then you go for trying to see, suppose you can do more than one work in parallel. And that is a very important concept in your project management. So probably when you talk about crashing of projects, this is something which you do. Today we are going to go very quickly through a building, the foundation part. So we are going to see the shuttering, and just remember that when you go for any other kind of shuttering estimate, the shuttering estimate is going to be the same. The same thing goes with the column and beam concreting or shuttering. So the principles are going to be the same. Okay. Now I am opening one of the projects which we have done, and probably one of the very important things is we should know how to read the construction drawing. Okay. Now this particular drawing was taken out from this Revit model. So here you can see the plinth beams, you can see the columns, the footing, and what you see below is the PCC. Okay, what you see below is the PCC for the mat. And you can, if you recollect, you'll find that is almost the same thing which we have done here also. Okay, right here we have done 50 mm thick PCC, but here there is a slight change in the thickness of the PCC. Okay, so block work is there, windows, doors, and all the other elements. So currently we are only going to try to see the foundation. Okay, so maybe I'll just show you a typical floor plan. So there are two classrooms here, there is a small outdoor learning space, staircase, and probably some minimum toilet facility has been provided here. So this is the drawing. So we are having footings of varying sizes. Okay, so basically what has happened is here we are having many, we could keep some smaller columns. So you'll find that the footing pad and other things have reduced in size. So this typically the classroom, you'll be able to make out that this would be the outline of the classroom. And yeah, so I'm sorry, this, there are two classrooms. and over here you are having the corridor, and over here you are having the staircase. Okay, so this is probably what you are seeing. Okay, now let's move on. We are going to find out what is the quantity for the column. Okay, as usual, you always try to use a standard BOQ sheet, and this is the standard BOQ sheet. Okay, so you need a serial number, description, numbers, length, breadth, and height. Okay, so coming back here, you can keep serial number, description, numbers, length, breadth, and height. After that, you can always have the quantity. Okay, now let us take number one. The advantage of this particular system is that, you know, I can just like that about draw lines, which unfortunately you guys may not have the luxury of doing. So in any case, if you are also following me with a pen and paper, but if you are doing so, it's very ideal, and I'll probably also encourage that to be done. Okay, so now I got all the things which I want, but other thing is that yes, I can also directly enter in this one, but I'm not going to do it right now. Okay, so basically when I go for earthwork, we have already told that we are going to take some space for working all around, and as a construction engineer, probably you will be seeing, oh, the space between these two footings is negligibly small. So what is the actual size between the two footings? The footing dimensions have been given in a table over here, 1300, and 1750 is the total space. Okay, so this means that the space which I have between the two footings is about 450 mm. Okay, and when I'm making a cut, the 450 mm, making the 450 mm stand up is very, very difficult. So I might as well make a deep cut throughout. Okay, so basically when you make this cut, it's going to look something like this. Okay, this is actually the excavation for the chiller plant which was there near our near SJT, and this is the column layout which they had over there. So you can see, suppose we are having some significant distance between the two footings, then probably you can have some space between them. But in the event that you don't have enough space, I'd rather that you make a full cut. But I'm not going for excavation in this calculation. We are going straight for concrete work. Okay. So now, if you look at concrete, you will be able to see the specification, like what is the grade of concrete and other things in the general notes. Okay. The general notes will give the specification of concrete and other things. So you're having M30 grade of concrete over here. I'm going to have 40 mm cover block for columns. Whatever is the description which you need is will be given in some place or the other. Okay. So here we have got that for columns, we are going to have 40 mm cover block. So it actually means that for this particular project, I'm going to need a few things. One, I see that there is PCC. 2, I see that there is a rebar. 3, there is concrete. And for doing the concrete effectively, I need a few things. I need shuttering, I need cover blocks. And if you look at a specification, and the specification says I want to have what we call as the anti-termite treatment done, then probably I had done the anti-termite treatment before doing the PCC. Okay, before I do the PCC, anti-termite treatment should also have been done. Okay, in the next session I will I'll just show you a photograph which kind of shows how the anti-termite treatment looks like. Okay, when it's going to be done. Okay, but as of now, I'm just going to go straight for the concrete chapter, and for that I'm going to do PCC, and I'm going to do rebar, and also probably the concrete. So concrete involves just doing the shuttering and the cover blocks. Now over here I am coming to the drawing. The column size is given as 1300 by 1300. Okay, so I am going to give, and also look at the numbers, I got 25 numbers. So directly I can give footing 25 numbers, and the length is 1.3 meters. Because I prefer to do it in cubic meters, we are going to keep it as 1.3 meters and breadth is 1.3 meters. And what is the depth of footing? It is 0.3 meters. So if you are having your calculator, I think it is a good idea that one of you cross checks the values with me. And here I am getting 12.675 meter cube. I am taking it as 12.7 meter cube. Typically the unit also has to be mentioned. So unit is meter cube. So this is footing. Which footing is this? This is footing number F1. Okay. So this is footing F1. Then I am taking footing F2. F2 is also same, but because of some reason we have got it as two numbers. We are given two different numerations, so we just leave it like that. So this is a 1.3 by 1.3 by 0.3. So this is 1.521. I am taking it as 1.5 meter cube. Now because the previous one was 12.6 something, and I'm just rounding this down to the lower value, and then I got 2.15 by 1.8 and 0.34 numbers, 0.3, and then F4 is again 3 numbers, 1.3 1.3 0.3. In this case I'm rounding it to one step higher. Okay, now it might seem a little funny, why is it that in one of the cases you are rounding up and in the other you are rounding down? In one of the cases, in the previous value, I had rounded up what I felt was a significantly high value. So I thought, okay, next value is quite low. I think it was 1.52. So instead of going what I call as cribbing, I just have gone to the higher value. So that at no point I am going to wind up with lesser material than what I require. So 4 into 2.15 into 1.8 into 0.3. So this is 4.64 and I am taking it as 4.7 meter cube. So this is the amount of concrete which we require. So when you look at it, what is the grade of concrete? The grade of concrete is M30. So we usually add a description, M30 concrete with whatever admixture and everything, because when this goes to the costing department, they will then know how much of the individual elements, like what are the admixtures they are adding, if you are adding some other performance enhancer, what is it that has to be added, all of those things go into the equation. So what is the total quantity of concrete? The total quantity of material which I require will be 12.7 plus 1.5 plus 4.7 plus 1.6. So this is 20.5 meter cube of concrete. Now you have got these values, you simply open your Delhi schedule of rate, and you open the Delhi analysis of rates, and go to the concrete chapter. Just go straight to the concrete chapter. So you can take whatever you feel is the closest value. See, for example, curbs, steps are not actually the one which you use for reinforced concrete. And yes, so what you can do is you can just choose whatever you feel is the item which suits your work the best. Now for us, if you see, we are having foundation, footings and bases for column. When I say bases for column, usually it is the pedestal. So you can look at all the things which are here and then use it as required. So now what we have done, we have found the total quantity of concrete. If you go a little higher up, you have the type of, you can choose what is the concrete which you are using and take into account all the costs and the quantity per unit meter of material. See, for example, here I am having 20.5 meter cube of concrete M30. So whatever is the mix ratio which you are doing, whether it is going to be a nominal mix where you have something like 1:1.5:3, or if you are going for a mix, pakka mix design where you might get all kinds of fractions and then you give a value, you need to find out that, you have to use those, you have to just get the mix ratio and then put it in your quantity, concrete, what you learnt in concrete technology or some other part, and then get the unit quantities. And you are going to put it into this form of table where you are taking into account each of the values. And please, again, I'm reminding you that whenever you're talking about masons and other laborers, it is a function of the organization. CPWD has assumed these values. If you're going to work for a contracting company, according to the what we call as the technology which the company has, you'll find that the number of laborers increases or decreases. Depending on the technology which you have, the whatever is the enabling thing like a tower crane or something else, you're going to find that the equipments which are going to be used is going to be also included in this. For example, here only vibrator is there and probably there will be a cement mixer somewhere. Whatever we've seen till now, I hope that all of you are kind of familiar. At least it should be something like a reminder of what we have already done. Now, moving on, when I look at this, when I'm going to go for shuttering, I'm going to have something slightly different. Here it was a cubic content. Here you'll have a something which is based on square meterage. Now, let me open the Delhi schedule of rates and look at the centering which they have done. Okay, this is the centering for a footing which they have done for 2.7 by 2.7 meters. And if you see, they are also saying the contact area is 10.8 square meters. Now look at what is the contact area for our case. The contact area for our case is, see, for example, let me take the contact area for F1. Contact area for F1, because if you look at F1, I am having 1, 2, 3 repeated types. So one of the things which I personally like to do in design is try to standardize all the sizes. Now, if you see, when you, if suppose for you, this particular class has a mix of structural engineers and construction managers. So, when the structural engineer does repetitive work, the amount of effort which is going for the the construction manager reduces. Because you are going to make, 1.3, one size as 1.1 and another as 1.4, you might save a little bit of concrete, but then the amount of time which the construction manager has to mobilize, the number of people you have to mobilize for doing the calculation and other things, it's going to be painful. So whatever savings you get in the design office will be only notional. If suppose your site man is not able to capitalize. So this is a small hint which I'm giving to all the structural engineers who are sitting here. Okay, because in an EPC company, most of the times you notice that you are under a lot of pressure to show savings. In other words, during the tendering, you might have given a quantity, and when you come for your actual execution, you need to show some savings to say that you're optimized. But then if you're going to optimize in these ways, why should I keep, for example, footing F3 as when footing F4 as 1.3, I will make it as 1. The amount of savings which you get, net savings, is actually very less. Okay, now let us see the contact area for F1. So for F1, the contact area will be, I'm just taking for what we will call as so let's go on. So here it is, I got a square this one. So typically the formula should be 2 into L plus B let me just adjust my pad a little. Yes, 2 into L plus B into height of footing. Okay, so this is equal to 2 into length is 1.3 plus 1.3 into 0.3. 2 into 1.3 plus 1.3 plus 0.3. Now, this is equal to, frankly, it will be very nice if suppose one of you could give me the answer, but in any case, 2 into 1.3 plus 1.3 into 0.3. So this is 1.56 meters only. But how many such are there? How many such footings are there? How many footings are there of this size? You will see that there are totally 31 footings. Can you see? In all, we are having 39 footings. So this is quite a significant number, correct? So the total contact area for F1 will be into 25 plus 3 plus 3, right? So now it becomes 1.56 into 31. So this is 48.36 meter square. Now look at the problem which we have over here. Now here it is 2.7 by 2.7 into 1. This is nothing but your contact area for one footing. Can you see here 2.7 into 2.7? If you do it, it is coming to 10.8 square meters. So here, in our particular case, the contact area for one is only 1.56. Okay, it is only 1.56. So for CPWD value, it is equal to, that is the footing is 2.7 by 2.7. This is the size which they have taken. So when you take, what is the surface area of this shutter required? 2 into 2.7 plus 2.7 into 1. So this is 2 into 2.7 into this one. So this is equal to 10.8 square meters. So I hope you are able to correlate between these two. So for me, currently this is the contact area which they have got over here. So this 10.8 square meters is going to be the basis with which you are working. You are seeing that they have assumed, they have taken an assumption that there is 40 times you are going to do the rework. Then the cost of maintenance is 10%. And then the salvage value is 25%. What does this mean? So when you are going to take into account a material like shutter, for example, if you take steel shutter, you have 40 times. This is again because it's a CPWD example, I use the same this one. So 40 times I can reuse. Then I'm going to have a 10% maintenance cost. So what are the maintenance you should do? Whenever you are going to remove the shutter, maybe it can get a little bent, so you need to clean it. Some concrete may be sticking onto it, you may have to chip it, and these kind of works you need to do. So this is the maintenance which you incur, and after you finish the whole process, I am going to sell it at 25%. So the initial value, if it is 100 rupees, when I sell it, it is 25 rupees, and I have also spent some money in what I call as maintaining it. So if this is positive, this is money that comes back to me, this is negative value. So this makes the overall coefficient come to 0.85, and this is the value which you see over here. Again, how did this 16 come? This 16 is coming because when I am taking a this particular case, when I say this particular case, the CPWD case, that's why I am putting this in blue. It is a 2.7 meter block of concrete which is there. So now I am going to take some shutter. What is the size of shutter? The size of the shuttering material is 1.25 by 500. Okay, so that means if I am going to do it, the panel will be 1.25, then there is one more 1.25 panel, and the height of this panel is 500. So I get 2.5, remaining I got 0.2. So I need to fill this with something else. And so now when you see, each face requires 4 such boards. So when I am going to take the whole thing, it is going to be 16 numbers. So that is why we are getting 16 into 0.5, and we are reusing it 40 times. So this makes it as the quantity which I require for each footing. For each square meter of work which you are doing, because this is going to be the only value which is going to repeat. I take 16 boards for this particular size of footing. Then what I do, I spend some money in maintenance, and then I get back some money because I'm selling the after the 40 times of using, I'm selling it back. Suppose I'm having aluminum shuttle 160 times reusability, that means that value will become 160. If my plywood is going to be able to do for max 10 times, okay, 4 times you can do, it will finish, will be good. Maybe I'm taking it to 10 times. So this is how you are going to get the wall form panel. Let us go ahead with our case. In our case, what is happening, we are having a 1.3 by 1.3, and what is the size of this panel? It is 1.25. It means when I am going to keep this piece of shutter, the CPWD shutter itself, it will be looking like this. Are you able to get it? The footing pad is 300. Okay, the footing pad is 300, and the shutter is taller than the footing pad. That means, actually speaking, there is some, what I call as, space which is not used. And in this particular case, how many these boards are required? Boards for putting the shuttering, I will be requiring, there are 4 sides. Okay, let me probably just draw this. So there are 4 sides, and on each side I will have to put this shuttering material. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So here my numbers become 4. One very important learning from this whole thing, just if you notice, you are actually going to get what I call as, in this particular case, you are going to get a little bit of wastage, because your surface area of contact is not the same. So this is one of the very important things probably which I'd like you to make a note of. Okay, for this 10.8 square meters, when I'm going to do, in other words, when I'm going to do for this 2.7 into 1, I am getting 1 value. On the other hand, if I'm going to change the size of the footing with the same shuttering board, there will be a difference. So you will not be able to make the shutter board of height lesser than the footing, and you cannot actually make it too big also than the size or dimension of the footing. And if you remember, in the previous class we had a few photographs. I guess it's here. Okay, now look at this. You are actually having to put some kind of stay so that the board doesn't move out of position. So you will need to calculate all of these values also, and these are the numbers which you get over here. Now for example, there is some corner angle which you add, and then there is some channel for the shoulder side, for putting in the side, and so on and so forth. and you can see the tubes, MS tubes. So what is happening over here, the 10.8, the contact area is coming into picture, and again, you know, your whatever you are going to get as the for reusability, and you are getting on 0.2295 over here. But if you look at probably the actual system what you are going to use, that would be the value which you are likely to use. So whatever is the, for example, if this the size of the channels which you take to keep the board vertical, if suppose you know the length is slightly more, there is no point in you saying I'm going to cut it. You're going to have to use it actually to the size in which you are getting itself. Okay, so this is probably the way by which you'll be doing the calculation of the number of shuttering boards which you will be using, because although you are measuring it in square meters, okay, for the structural engineer it's very easy. The design office, we simply measure everything and then give the value in square meters. However, in practice, it is not in square meters that people do. In today's class, we have actually seen how we can estimate the shuttering in terms of cost because of the fact that we are reusing. Because of the fact that we are reusing the shutter and we are spending some money on maintenance, and also some money is got from selling the at the end of the life the shuttering material, you are getting some money back. So it kind of the cost which you get is not, you know, the actual cost of the shutter itself. So you may buy the shuttering material for 100 rupees, but then you are spending some money on maintaining it, so that makes it 110. And if you're selling it for 25 rupees, the net money which you spend is actually 85 rupees. So whatever is the thing which goes in, for example, it might be the whenever there's a small space, you know, where the shuttering board might not come, you may have to put some plywood or some other filler material. So you need to have an estimate of all of those things and some of the enabling works, like maybe channels to keep the shuttering board in place or some kind of stay arrangement if you are doing. So for each of these, it is mandatory that you guys estimate it properly, because if you miss it, okay, there will be actually nobody who can actually help you out on this. Okay, so if you have any questions, please ask. I hope you found this session useful. And when you go for other levels also, when you go for other levels like for slab, for whatever is the other material, whatever is the other item which you are doing, this will be the concept which you will be using. Okay, find out whatever has to go in. For example, shutter release material, is it there or not? If you don't take it into account, the cost is not going to be estimated. So you have to be very careful. And one more thing, for example, the anti-termite treatment is linked sometimes to the PCC which you have, and then again just below the floor you can also have, depending on the system of the anti-termite treatment that you choose. So you have to have a very good understanding of whatever is the construction material which is coming in. So what are the do's, what are the don'ts, because many of the times you'll find that the material is supplied and you will be the person who is going to apply it. For example, the water treatment system which we have in the new ladies hostel is a very unique system. It's an active passive system which probably we don't usually get to see in most of the sites. So when we saw it, we learned that, you know, there's a better system that has come in, and the application was very easy. I mean, it didn't require much effort. So the material was supplied by the supplier and we could have our own people do it. On the other hand, there were some other works where we did some roof waterproofing, where, you know, the applicator and the was the supplier. We could not hire our own people because it required special tools and also skill for applying that water treatment course. So whatever you are going to do, so it means when I'm getting the product, it becomes a turnkey. Waterproofing becomes a turnkey contract, and I just have a number. I just have to fill it, and then my cost estimate for that work is done. On the other hand, if suppose that is not the case, you have to very carefully analyze what are the pros and cons of the system. You need to know what you can do, what you should not do, how it's being done, what are the manpower and what are the tools and plant which is required. So when you have an idea of all of this, you'll be in a very good position to do your estimate. Before we close, can I request Pandian TK, if you are around, to please summarize what you have done in class today?
Yes, sir, I can hear.
Yeah, can you just summarize what we did in class today?
Yes, sir. So first, we have seen the estimation for footing, sir. Hmm? Footing, and we have discussed about shuttering calculations.
Okay. Any salient point you have? Maybe I'll ask somebody else.
Yes, sir, I can hear you, sir.
Yes, Shivaram. Shivaram, can you just add on what all are the things which we should see when we are doing the shuttering, please? Calculating for shuttering.
Sir, we need to see about the contact area, sir.
Okay.
We need to calculate the contact area.
Very good.
And we need to parallelly see the rates in daily schedule of rates.
Okay. One thing I'll add, please don't take only the daily schedule of rates, because sometimes the daily schedule of rates is only indicative, and you know, the same product in your city, because of inflation, it would have gone up. See, this is 2019, now 2020, let us say that there is, because maybe because of the COVID virus situation also, there is a material which is in short supply. That means people are not able to get that material. Maybe it may be a tap, maybe it can be something like that. So you are not able to get that material. So what happens, the rate is not the same as what is there in the daily schedule of rates. So this is something which you should be very, very cautious upon. Okay. Yeah, please proceed. I'm sorry to have interrupted you.
Sir, and we looked at footing, sir. We calculated about the footing, and we found out that around 20.3 meter cube of concrete is required for footing.
Okay.
And then we looked at some of the photographs in the site, realistic photographs, sir.
Okay.
And actually, in between, your voice was muted for some time, so.
Okay, I request you to please go back to the recording and then do the needful. And
yes,
one
sir.
Last person, probably Jinsi Elizabeth, are you around?
Yes, sir.
Right, great. Okay, now I'll just ask you to tell a little bit about how you can see something on the screen, right, where we are talking about how much money is going to be spent on a particular item. In this case, it was a shuttering board. So can you just give one very brief summary and then we can close the session?
Sir, consider the contact area, and depending on that, you determine how many number of the board, shuttering board, what area it will cover.
Okay.
And if it is going, the area of the shuttering board is going above, then the number of boards you have to use is less.
Actually, if the shuttering board is projecting beyond the footing, that means you are actually using the surface area of board which you require is more than this contact area. Are you able to get it? So please be a little cautious in that particular light, because that's a little tricky. So yes, but in any case, more or less, I hope that all of you found this session useful. If you have any questions, you are welcome to ask, and I'll request you to please take this time to go and see how these calculations are done, because we have now taught you the principle of how the Delhi schedule of rate, Delhi analysis of rate works. We will not be probably able to do each and every problem. But I assume that, you know, when somebody talks about, you know, COPOH, so at least then you'll be in a position to say, yeah, it's contractor's profit. And what is OH? Anybody? Somebody, please. OH stands for overheads. Okay. So COPOH, contractor profit and overheads. Right. So thanks a lot for joining.